We can see the sandbar, which is just in behind us by about 20 feet. But there is a gap over there near shore. Now the idea is to get it past the lazy jacks, which is only a very small amount up. This is why I love having crew. Much easier. Now we don't have a big surplus of wind, but the tide's with us. We're doing a reach at the moment. And we are moving. So Matthew's got the day off from Auckland. Thought he'd come and play golf, but apparently the golf course was already booked for something else. So we've had to put up with him a bit earlier, which is no great ordeal. Right, well, it was for variable, 0.0 wind. So we're currently going with the tide diagonally sideways. Anyway, we are actually heading in the right direction, 1.2 knots. Well, there's sticking it out and there's being silly, so we will engage Iron Genoa. Oh, we're just running on the starboard engine. Tide's going out, be nice to get to where we're going before it turns against us. Tahi, and we'll go inside Passage Island. We've got one looks like fully laden log ship in North Port, so I expect it'll be leaving soon, and one tanker at Marsden Point. Decommissioned refinery, now just an import terminal. We'll drop the main. I think we'll go and anchor in Little Munro Bay. Rounding Lort Point, and Little Munro Bay is past that half eaten away rock, with Mount Manaia of course coming into view. And looking back to where we came between Passage Island and the mainland. Oh, there's Little Munro Bay underneath Mount Manaia. Here we are anchored Little Munro Bay. The road goes up there to join the Heads Road. See the top of Mount Manaia over the ridge. Is up around to the left. There's the harbour entrance and Marsden Point, and around to the right is the beginning of Northport. Oh, it's now 7:30. Forecast is for variable going to northerly 10, this afternoon. So we're going to pick up Granddad later on this morning. We have a couple of ships in the southern anchorage out towards Bream Tail, which was the direction we were at last weekend. Steady stream of fizz boats heading out for a fish. Oh, the sun has appeared. Got him at work again. Definitely fish here. Carway, I presume, chasing something. The seagulls also chasing the wee ones on the surface. But of course, you can't fish for them. Not here. Strong incoming tide at the moment, and I've made Matthew put the main up, so hopefully there'll be enough wind to sail up to Pārua Bay, which is just coming into view past the end of this, which is Passage Island. Westerly, really. It's supposed to go around to the north. Right, ready about?
Yep.
Leo. See, no winching required if done well. And we have a marine professional on the job. of close reach now into Parua Bay. I would imagine there's not a lot of wind in there, but we'll need to drop the sails anyway as we go to the pontoon to pick up Granddad, aka Salty Old Sea Dog. Well, we're in the lee of Moto Kiori Island in Parua Bay. That's Endomanganese Point there. And as expected, the wind is dying off in the shelter here. Now there's the nook and the white designed catamaran that was at North Sand for many years. The first boat you get to is launched and currently anchored over there. Salty Old Sea Dog and Salty Old Sea Dog seat. Look, he's winching again. Matthew's made morning tea for us all. A number of large yellow buoys have appeared and this boat's going past with flags flying. There's a whole lot of very fast boats sitting up here, so I suspect there's powerboat racing, so that might be interesting to watch. We're getting closer to the conglomeration of boats. There's not a lot of wind, ideal for powerboating. Not a lot of wind. Oh, we are. chat to the marker boat and move to the inside of the course. They're very happy for us to be here. We're anchored, still got the main up. Oh, that's not good. Their engine covers up. Obviously piston broke. Here comes the leader. Well, they seem to have an engine start over here now. Maybe it was overheating. Here comes the one that was parked up. Managed to cook and we've had lunch in the middle of all that. Main's still up, no wind to speak of, getting damn hot. Sure, that's not the way to go. Enjoyed that. Yeah, only once a year will be enough, thank you, but it was dead calm, so not much else we could do. The wind's now coming up, so we'll tack up harbour against the tide. Well, it's a bit slower going against the tide, but we do have a reasonable breeze. We seem to have run out of wind again, so we'll head that way and maybe in an hour we'll get there. Well, I don't think we're even going to make it to Pareo Bay as the tide's taking us past it. And as you can see, there's a hurricane blowing out here. But all is not lost. There's a seagull on top of the danger mark. Before we get swept past the entrance to Pareo Bay, I've engaged the iron Genoa. Here's the nook. Here's the white catamaran from Norsand Boatyard. Good to see them back on the water. There's the scow from a couple of weekends ago. That normally is on a mooring on the other side of Pareo Bay. Another seagull stopping the marker from getting blown away. Now there's the head of Pareo Bay. We're anchored in Munro Bay. A bit of a breeze come up now. That'll give us some cooling this evening. It's 7 o'clock. A calm night with a heavy dew. It's 8 o'clock. Sun's just about to appear over the top of that hill. Matthew's got people he wants to visit, so we'll be heading back. Anchor's coming up.